Hi, I'm Ms. Hearn. In the previous video, we set up this Venn diagram to analyze the results of a survey. In this video, we're going to answer questions about the results of the survey using the Venn diagram. Set M represents the students who like Mozart. Set B represents the students who like Beethoven. And set H represents the students who like Haydn. So, if you were asked how many of these students like none of these composers, then they're asking you about region 8, and you would say 1. Let's consider another question you might be asked about the survey, the results of the survey. How many students like exactly 2 of these composers? You might think, well, the students that like Mozart and Beethoven would be here, and the students who like Mozart and Haydn would be here. And the students who like Haydn and Beethoven would be here. So you might think we have to add up 5, 9, 13, and 7. But that would be counting region 1, which is not actually students who like exactly 2 of the composers. They like at least 2, but in fact they like all 3. So instead, we need only those regions which only like 2 composers. So for example, here region 4 is students who are in the M and the B group, but not the H group. So they only like Mozart and Beethoven. And here we have a region that falls into the Mozart group and the Haydn group, but not the Beethoven group. So they like exactly 2 as well. And then here we have all the students who are in the M set and the H set, but not the M set. So they like Haydn and Beethoven, but not Mozart. So it's these 3 specific regions that like exactly 2 of the composers. So you would have to add up the number in region 4 plus the number in region 2 plus the number in region 3, which is going to be 5 plus 13 plus 7 equals 25. There are 25 students who like exactly 2 of the composers. Now, if I said at least 2, you'd throw in those other 9, but I didn't. I said exactly 2. Here's another question. How many of these students like exactly 1 of these composers? Okay, so for example, which region or regions have students that only like Beethoven? So that would be region 7, which has 16 people that surveyed in this region. These are the ones that only like Beethoven. But then there's also the ones in region 5, 4 of them, who only like Haydn. And then there's also the ones in region 6 here who only like Mozart, but not either of the other 2 composers. So in fact, to answer this question, we have to take the number in region 5 plus the number in region 6 plus the number in region 7. That's going to be 4 plus 11 plus 16. That's going to be 31. 31 students who like exactly 1 composer. Okay, and now one more question. How many of these students like Mozart, but neither Beethoven nor Haydn? Okay, so we're looking for the number that are in M, and they are not in B, so they're in B complement, and they are not in H. This would be how you'd write that symbolically. Okay, but what are we describing? We're describing the elements that are in set M, but don't overlap with B or H. The only region that fits that description is region 6. Students who like Mozart but are not part of this group that like Haydn, and they're not part of the group that like Beethoven. So just this chunk right here. So that's going to be 11. 11 students that fall into that description. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please remember to give it a like. That helps other students to find the video.